I'm going to say... Shall I say it? I'm going to say it. The smart home industry is Britney Spears right now. It started out really cool and pretty, and then eventually shaved its head and asked Kevin Federline for the kids back. Philips Hue will charge exorbitant fees just to match the colour of our lights to our TV. A gajillion pounds! If This Then That will charge a subscription fee for products you already paid for,
you'll pay now, immediately.
And Jeff Bezos just hasn't got enough yachts. Not enough yachts. Today's video is four reasons that the smart home industry is basically a complete train wreck, and why it is so difficult to start a smart home in 2021. Everything! Smart home companies are just giving up, left, right, and center. Logitech, for example, have just decided to stop making their line of Harmony turds. New from Logitech, the Harmony turd. I actually really like their remote, but the Harmony hub was just preposterously expensive and was destroyed by the Broadlink equivalent, which was less than half the price. I gave them an awful lot of grief about this over the years, but instead of innovating or lowering their price tag, they just packed up their shit and went home. It's like if Luke Skywalker was doing the trench run on the Death Star and Admiral Akbar just gave him the little bit of criticism and Luke Skywalker was like, I don't have to take this.
Use the Force, Luke.
Luke, we need you to concentrate. The universe is counting on you.
I don't have to take crap from you, Admiral Akbar. You're just a fish.
So now there's no such thing as a universal smart home remote. The industry is completely devoid of any universal smart home remote. And Samsung SmartThings, they just bowed out of the market entirely. They were like,
we're stopping production of all of our equipment entirely, but we're not leaving the smart home race. No. We're going to continue to let you use our servers entirely for free. We will have no income at all, but you can keep using them for free forever at our expense.
I see no reason that this will eventually become a subscription-based service.
Hello, darkness, my old friend.
Unfortunately, this is the danger of the smart home industry right now, is that almost every company has some cloud-based service, if for no other reason but so that their devices can talk to She That Should Not Be Named and Google Home. Those servers cost money to run, and if there's no new income coming in for Samsung SmartThings or Logitech for their Harmony remotes, well then welcome to your shiny new doorstop. The new Harmony doorstop from Logitech. That was £115 well spent. The shiny little shit. That bubble's gonna burst.
And now, a word from our sponsors! You! Yes, you! You look like you've been shoveling greasy fast food into that gullet because you're too busy with your hectic lifestyle of doing basically nothing! Yeah. If you want to get fitter this year and make the ladies giddy, then you'll need to routinely eat the government recommended amount of ham, eggs, steak, bacon, and chickens! But what if you don't always have time to eat the recommended number of animals? That's when I turn to huel for a nutritionally complete product packed with protein. Huel Black Edition is their lowest carb product yet, with 33% more protein and 50% lower carbs. One huel meal contains all the protein, carbohydrates, good fats, and fiber that the body needs. For just £1.50 per meal and 30 seconds of preparation time, you can get 40 grams of protein with no artificial sweeteners, and it's made out of plants! I know! Preposterous! I have huel for breakfast when I'm at the local gymnasium to help me reach my goals the nutritionally complete way. And with my first order, I received an entire month's worth of huel, a shaker, a t-shirt, and a handy guide to get me started. Ham and eggs and steak with bacon. And chickens. Or just get yourself some huel. And now back to our main feature!
Here and now, in 2021, I cannot use this door sensor from Shelly to turn on these plug sockets from Lightwave RF. Do you know why?
Corporate greed!
But it's not actually Shelly and Lightwave that are greedy. It's a whole group of companies called the Zigbee Alliance. A long time ago, a universal language was created so that smart home company A's product would be able to speak to smart home company B's product. This language was called Zigbee, but the Zigbee Alliance made product certification so expensive that all of the smaller smart home companies went, "I'm not doing that then, I will just use Wi-Fi, or RF, or Bluetooth, or even infrared, anything other than Zigbee because it's too expensive to go and get my product certified." On top of this, some companies such as Philips Hue took the Zigbee protocol and added some security features to make it so that if you did add other third-party Zigbee products, they would have limited functionality compared to the Philips equivalent. Such a coincidence. It made us all want to only buy Philips Hue for some reason. It's funny that whenever us customers are getting screwed, it's always for the same reason.
Security. Something to do with security.
Fragmentation is the number one problem in the smart home industry right now, and the Zigbee Alliance are having another crack at solving it again with something called CHIP. 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 We'll talk more about that shortly. Two down, two to go. Amazon or the devil? Literally the devil. Because what happens in the smart home industry is companies innovate and make amazing things, but they're always hobbled with a lack of Spotify. And then Amazon comes along, makes exactly the same thing, puts Spotify in it, and charges £5 more money. We all pay the £5 more money, and the original product dies a death.
Someone's just bought a toilet with Alexa. Put Spotify on it, charge £5 more, put that dumb smiley face on it, and kill that company!
The new Echo Bowl from Amazon. It eats your poo. Anker's version of the Echo Auto put She That Should Not Be Named into our cars for all of about 2 minutes before Amazon released this big dumb idiot into the market.
Hi everybody, I'm Amazon's face. I like to drive your car.
Anker's product was crushed instantly. And why?
Not enough yachts.
When is there going to be some governance? The telecommunications industry has a company called Ofcom, which oversees it to make sure that there isn't a monopoly on products and to make sure that people are acting fairly. The smart home industry has nothing, and seemingly it's whoever has the biggest lawyers and the most money. Guess who that is? It's Amazon. Then there's the brand new smart home protocol, the Magic CHIP, which is going to revolutionize the smart home industry by allowing this button from Xiaomi to turn on this light bulb from Philips Hue. The fact that there is already a protocol that can do this called Zigbee is seemingly entirely irrelevant. And CHIP is supposed to be replacing Zigbee to rescue us from the mess caused by all that corporate greed we mentioned.
Whoa there, trusty steed! I am Sir CHIP! I am here to rescue you from the smart home companies that ensured your equipment wouldn't be able to talk to one another. The fact that I am those companies all stood on top of each other in a white knight costume shouldn't be suspicious at all.
I trust them! And so all of the industry's greatest enemies have come together to standardize the smart home industry. Again. Because they're the same people that invented the Zigbee protocol for exactly this reason. It's exactly the same bullshit happening all over again. And I've just been catching up on all the latest news from the CHIP Alliance, who are still calling themselves CHIP for some reason. They obviously can't spell connected home over IP. And apparently, Philips are already saying, yes, we will work with the CHIP Alliance, but you will still need one of these. Now, why would I still need one of these if these things were going to start speaking the same language as everybody else? This would no longer be necessary, would it? Except, of course, that's not how Philips are gonna do it. This thing will work with CHIP, this thing won't, to make sure you all still have to buy one of these. Shall we sing the song together, children?
Corporate greed, Philips and their corporate greed, Philips and their greed.
So, if the CHIP Alliance are going to allow Philips Hue to put a bridge between the outside world and the Philips Hue products, and they're undoubtedly going to bow to Apple when Apple say, well, we want to have HomeKit certification on CHIP products that will work with our platform, so we'll have a security layer that will only allow certain products to work with our stuff, then that means... It's exactly the same as Zigbee! Google are yet to make a speaker that understands the difference between on and off.
Off! On.
Apple are still living in a fantasy land where they can break into the smart home industry by releasing a product you can only use if you have an iPhone. Philips Hue are still charging a bajillion pounds for light bulbs that are dimmer than Lidl's own brand.
A gajillion pounds!
And the customer is just left wondering which gadgets to invest in, which gadgets are going to work with what other gadgets, and when is Jeff Bezos going to send a dystopian attack helicopter to burn down my house?
The new dystopian attack helicopter from Amazon. Because Jeff Bezos has enough money to make you disappear.
No, just me that worries about that. Okay then. There is still hope on the horizon, don't let me bring you down. I really love the smart home industry still, and every single week I am bringing new things to your attention because I am excited by those things. I hope that the current situation spurs on the team behind Home Assistant.
Home Assistant!
Because Home Assistant over the last couple of years has become an incredible way to tie all of your smart home gear together, and it's becoming more and more accessible to non-nerds and nerds alike. The only thing you have to remember is that software without hardware is like Mr. Socky without my arm.
What are you trying to say, you little bitch?
Apparently still sentient and murderous with rage. The smart home community is one big hole. And if you don't understand that, then you too are one big hole. Smart home technology is still the most exciting technology in the world. Even though it's still kind of the Wild West out there, this is the most exciting time to get in on this stuff. Things are changing rapidly, but if you buy the right products, it doesn't really matter. All of that stuff is irrelevant as long as you are protected. You can protect yourself quite easily simply by buying products that have resilience. If it's a Zigbee-based solution, there will always be some kind of Zigbee controller that can control that Zigbee-based solution. Don't buy it from Philips Hue. There is a list of products in the description that I recommend that have either that level of resilience or are so cheap it doesn't really matter if they only last a couple of years. They're ridiculously good value for money, and they probably will last anyway. I hope you've enjoyed today's video. If you have, please give it a thumbs up. That'll tell YouTube's algorithms it was a good video, and more people should see it. If you want to see some more of this guy, hit that subscribe button and ding that bell. If you ding the bell, it lets YouTube know that you want to be notified when I upload videos. These incredible people here are my patrons from Patreon, and seriously, they keep this channel going. I say it every week, I sound more ridiculous every single time, but honestly, without them, there would be no channel. If you want to be one of those guys, you can do that at either Patreon or buy me a one-off beer at PayPal, and either way, I would genuinely love you forever. These are my Facebooks and my Twitters and my Instagrams. Come and hang out there and we can be best friends. See you next time. Pew pew, Philips Hue. That's way too stupid. That's not gonna work. I hate Paul Hibbert. You want things that are either gonna have longevity? Say the word correctly. You want to be buying things that have longevity? Oh man, I can't say longevity. Philips Hue and a few other companies. Yeah.